This is Jurassic Guest here. Today we're checking out Pretzel Rocks. This service allows us to get free music for our YouTube or Twitch live streams that is completely copyright free. So all you have to do is click the sign up button. It's going to either have you sign in with Twitch or sign in with your Google account. If you have the free version, a bot is going to sit there and pop up in chat and tell you every single new song that is playing, unless you pay for a more premium version. Now you can play in the browser or you can download the client. If you download the client, you do have a little bit of extra features, such as being able to show what song is playing on the stream itself. But considering the fact that the bot says it in the chat, I don't think it's necessarily too useful, but I'll show you how to do that too. So for now, we're just going to click play in browser. If we click the settings icon down here, scroll down a little bit. This is the audio quality. Now you can have audio output device. It's probably going to be set at default, so we'll just do that now. You are going to have to click this refresh button down here, and this is basically is going to turn on all audio sources possible for them to figure out which audio sources are actually being able to be used. Now, if you want to have it so it plays all the time on your game volume, for example, just leave it at default. I have it on a different track, that way it's not too overbearing. That way you can sort of customize the hertz and everything of each different track. So we'll just leave it at default for now. And if you have YouTube Safe Mode enabled, it won't play a song that is not YouTube friendly. So YouTube Safe Mode pretty much guarantees the royalty-free ownership of the song. That way you're able to play it on YouTube, so you know for 100% sure that Twitch shouldn't have any issues at all. So I would definitely have YouTube Safe Mode. And probably check off Allow Mature. Basically, it has more adult songs. So if you come over here into stations, there's several different categories you can pick from chill all the way down to rock, heavy metal, things of that. I'll do rock, so I'm going to click on that. As long as YouTube Safe is on, only songs that actually work with YouTube will be playing. So you can sit here and change the volume, and it will adjust in real time. So I guess let's go like half volume or something. That sounds good, and basically that's it for the browser. Now, if you do decide to go ahead and download the plugin, open it up, and it's basically going to bring you to this page here. You're going to have to go into the settings and do everything with your monitor again to enable audio source. Have it on my projector, which you guys will see in a second why we do that. But everything else should be the exact same, and you can have it so it writes the track. So you want to make sure this little button is checked. Then you go into your settings and basically you put it wherever you want. For example, I have it in my OBS folder. It's just going to make one .txt file that's like 2 kilobytes or something. So it's an extremely small file, and basically all it does is updates the words every single time. So once that is done, you want to open up OBS. If you have OBS opened, go ahead and click the plus sign, go into audio output capture, and you want to name it whatever you want. For example, this is going to be Pretzel, so we'll just do that. Default device, you want to click on whatever device that you have the Pretzel app going to. So for example, mine is on the Epson projector, so I'm going to go and click that. Once you're all done, click OK. Now, right now the music will be playing on our vocal track, so to fix that, click on Advanced Audio Properties. Look for whatever track your vocal cord is on. For example, mine is on track 3. And you want to go to Pretzel and unselect the audio track for track 3. So basically that should allow Pretzel to only be on track 1, 2, 4, 5, and 6. So you can sort of customize whatever tracks that you want to do. For example, I typically do my voice on one track, my friends on another. Gain volume on the last, and then have pretty much track 6 is like my dedicated streaming audio track to have all my audio settings there. So to do that, go into output. Now stream is basically where you can pick whichever output track that you want. For example, I stream on the 6th track, so make sure that has a black dot on it. You won't see it since I'm recording at the moment. And for recording, you can basically select however many audio tracks you want. I typically do the first 3, so game, volume, friend, slash music, and my voice. So that's why I only have 3 selected. So now all that is set up. Pretzel is basically going to be playing in the background, and you can see right here the slider is going up and down, and you can customize this so you can, you know, change it however much you want. You don't want to do it too overbearing. Definitely make sure it's not inside the red zone any at all, so probably around 15-20 area. For example, this song is around negative 7.2 decibels. Now, if you want the song name to pop up on the screen, click the plus sign down here. Go over into text GDI plus and name it whatever you want. For example, we'll just call it music. You can select whatever font you want. It pretty much has every single Google font possible. We'll just pick something like this and do whatever size you want. So for this tutorial, we're going to do 72. So it's easy to see. And basically, you want to have read from file selected, click browse, and it should automatically pull you up. It pulls us up to the OBS folder where we put the audio track in the Pretzel application. You can see it right here. And basically, all you have to do is click open. It's going to pop up and automatically get the song name for you. So this is where you can customize like the colors and everything. I think gradients look really cool. So I'm just going to have a gradient, select a color, and I'm going to do like a green, and it's going to make like a really cool green and white effect. Then you can basically change the gradient's opacity and everything else like that. And that's kind of cool too, but we'll probably do it like that. And you can change the direction, so it just sort of plays around with the different weights. So you can sort of have it like that, or you can have it back in the middle where they had it. Now the background opacity basically puts a black bar around it, which I mean, it looks all right, but I definitely think it looks better with a clear background. So click OK, and basically you are all set. Now, if we come back into the Pretzel application, you can see Santiago's Lamina is playing right now. If we click on the skip track, it's going to have a 5-second delay, which we set earlier. In 5 seconds, it will update just like that. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.